students, a very good morning to you. We have completed male reproductive system in our last class, that is of class 12 chapter 3, and the name of chapter is human reproduction. As we know that human beings reproduces by means of sexual reproduction, or we can say that in case of human beings we see sexual reproduction. So before do sexual reproduction, we have some remarkable changes, means the changes we can see in, starting from puberty up to death. Our body saw different changes. So in the last class, I have explained you about the human male reproductive system. Now today, I am going to teach you about the female reproductive system. As we know that the female reproductive system, like the human male reproductive system, the female reproductive system is consists of a pair of ovary, oviduct, uterus, vagina, and external genitalia. Clear students? Along with cervix also. So where these organs present, what is their function, and how they help in forming gamete? As you know that in case of human males, the formation of sperm is called as spermatogenesis, that is included in pre-fertilization event, which I have told you. And here formation of ovum is called as oogenesis. We will study later. So let's know about the organs of female reproductive part. So first let's see ovary. What is ovary? Ovary is the primary sex organ in human females. Here one question comes, what is primary sex organ and what is secondary sex organ? Primary sex organ is the organ which is present from birth, and secondary organ is the organ which we identify, the organ which refers to any particular person, whether it is a male or female, means without seeing the sex organ, we able to identify whether she is a female or he is a male. That is the character of secondary sexual character. Suppose for example, if a person wears beard and mustache, then we can say that he has development of secondary sexual character. That is secondary sex organ. And in primary sex organ, as I have told you, in case of human females, ovary is present from birth. That's why it is called as primary sex organ. Clear students? Here another thing. These are the parts of human reproductive part. Clear? Along with these parts, the mammary gland is also included in the female reproductive part. Why mammary gland? Considered. Remember, as mammary gland plays an important role after parturition, means after giving birth to a child, the mammary gland have an important role as it nourishes the growing fetus, growing child. That's why mammary gland is also included in this. We will study about this later. Let's study about ovary. Ovary is like testis. Ovary is also present in the pelvis region of human female body. And it is present in pair. Ovary is present in pair. And it is looks like an inverted pear-shaped structure. Inverted pear. You know about pear. Pear is a fruit. That ovary looks like an inverted pear shape. And its length is about 2 to 4 cm. 2 to 4 cm. The length of ovary is 2 to 4 cm, which we know. And it is connected with the pelvic wall. Pelvic wall means, I have told you what is pectoral and what is pelvic. Initially, I already told you that pelvic region means the lower part of the body, means at the lower abdominal region, that is called pelvis region. So it is connected with the pelvic wall of the body. Clear students? And again, it is covered by thin epithelium tissues. You studied about epithelium tissues in class 11. So ovary is covered by thin epithelium tissue, and it has two layers, the outer layer and the inner layer. The outer layer is called as cortex and inner layer is called as medulla, means outer cortex or peripheral cortex. Outer cortex or peripheral cortex, and this is inner medulla. Means the ovarian wall is divided into two parts. One is outer cortex and another is inner medulla, and the ovary is covered by a thin epithelial tissue. Means the epithelial tissue protects the ovary. Clear students? Next, is your oviduct. Oviduct is the part which carries the ovum from ovary to the uterus. Clear, students? So oviduct oviduct has four parts, and that are infundibulum, ampulla, isthmus, and fimbri. Clear, students? So oviduct has four parts: fimbri, infundibulum, ampulla, and isthmus. So let's write their name. Oviduct has four parts, means this, I will draw the diagram, you can see. This part is consist of fimbri, then infundibulum, then ampulla, and isthmus. These are the parts of oviduct. Then uterus is the cavity, or we can say as uterine cavity, where implantation of the zygote occurs. Then the vagina is the passage through which the sperm enters into the female body, as well as the ovum, unfertilized ovum also released through the vagina. And here I have right cervix. Cervix is known as birth canal, through which the birth of child occurs. That is called as cervix. And the mammary gland, you know that mammary gland is a pair of structure whose growth and development occurs after puberty. And inside the mammary gland, there is synthesis and formation of milk occurs, which provides nutrition after parturition. Clear, students? So let's draw the diagram of human female reproductive system, and let's see what are its different parts. As you know that the human female reproductive system is consist of a pair of ovary. So you can see here, this is an ovary and this is also an ovary. So it is a pair. And as you know that it has oviduct. So let's see the diagram. This part is like this. You can see the diagram, how I am drawing it. Then see the diagram. This will help you to draw. Clear, students? This is the diagram. Now let's label it. What are its different parts? This is ovary. This part is called as oviduct. Again, I will show you the four parts. This part is called as uterus. This part is called as vagina. And this part is called as cervix. Clear, students? So oviduct has four parts. First part is called as fimbri. The finger-like structure you can see here, they are called as fimbri. Clear? Just above the fimbri, the funnel-shaped structure, which is called as infundibulum. Infundibulum. Just above infundibulum, there is ampulla. And then isthmus. Clear, students? So they are the different parts. You can see that this is fimbri, which is finger-like structure. Then just above the fimbri, there is infundibulum, then your ampulla, and then isthmus. And here is the uterine fundus. This is uterine fundus. Clear? And this part is called as uterus, where the implantation of zygote occurs, and this part is called as cervix, or we can say as birth canal. And this part is the called vagina, through which the sperm enters into the body. And this part is called as cervical canal, which leads to cervix. This part is called as cervical canal. So this is the diagram of human female reproductive system. Here is the pair of ovary. And here is the ligament which connects the ovary with the uterine wall. This is called as ligament. And this connects the ovary with the uterus. Clear, students? So these are the different parts. And fallopian tube, as I have told you, is consist of fimbri, infundibulum, ampulla, and isthmus. You have to remember the names. They are most important. Fimbri, infundibulum, ampulla, and isthmus. Here, millions of ovary is formed during the petal life or petal stage of the embryo female fetus. Then after maturity, means after puberty, the fimbria collects only one ovum, and then it passes through the different parts of the oviduct and come towards the uterus. If fertilization occurs, then zygote implant. If not occur, then it comes in the form of blood and mucus through the vaginal opening, which is called as menstrual cycle. So students, next which we will study, that external genitalia. What is external genitalia? Here I have already told you about cervix and cervical canal, vaginal. Then external genitalia is consist of, or external genitalia is called as vulva. In case of females, the names are, female reproductive system, the names are very important. So be careful and remember the names. Vulva is consist of, means the external sex organ in case of female is called vulva, and it is consist of, first part is called as mons pubis. The first part is called mons pubis, and the next part is called as labia majora. Labia majora. Then the third part is called as labia minora. Then the next part is called as clitoris. Then hymen. Clear students? Mons pubis, labia majora, labia minora, clitoris and hymen together constitute the external genitalia of human female, which is called as vulva. Mons pubis is the area where hairs arise after puberty. Then labia majora is the infoldings of the clitoris, which covers clitoris. This is the large infolding, and just below it there is a pair of small infolding, that is called as labia minora. And next is clitoris, which is bell-shaped structure, and that present just above the urethra. And hymen is the partially covered structure, which covers the vagina partially. And hymen has also many important characters, and hymen also shows some changes, or we can see the change in hymen, which we will discuss in the classroom. This can be discussed through the video. So students, next move to the mammary gland. Here I have explained you about the external genitalia. Next, mammary gland. As you know that the mammary gland is a characteristic feature of every human female, as it produces milk, which gives nourishment or nutrition to the child. That's why mammary gland also is very important part. And the mammary gland is consists of lactiferous ducts, where during lactation milk is sucked by the child, and it has also different parts, which we can see through diagram. Mammary lobe, mammary alveolus, ampulla, mammary duct and lactiferous duct, then nipple. Means they are combiningly forms the mammary gland, through which milk is released after parturition by the female or by the mother. So students, this is all about your female reproductive system. Now we will proceed the topic. Here are some topics which we can discuss through video, so I skip this. Next we will study about the next means pre-fertilization event, that is gamete formation. Here we are know that how male organ, male reproductive organ and female reproductive organs are present and their function. Now we will study about gametogenesis. So you know that what is gametogenesis? Gametogenesis is two types. In case of male, it is called as spermatogenesis, and in case of female, it is called as oogenesis. So spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Spermatogenesis means formation of sperm, and oogenesis means formation of, this is formation of sperm, and this is formation of ovum. And both these processes, means spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Spermatogenesis occurs after puberty, but oogenesis takes place during the fetal stage of the female child. Means oogenesis, the formation of ovum occurs when the female child is inside the mother's body. This is the exception. We will study more about this. First, we will study about spermatogenesis. So, what is spermatogenesis? You already know. Let's see how this process occurs. As we know that this is spermatogonia. This is spermatogonia whose ploidy is 2n. And around spermatogonia, there are Sertoli cell is present. This is Sertoli cell. This is Sertoli cell. This is spermatogonia. And around the spermatogonia means outside the spermatogonia and around the Sertoli cell, there is Leydig cell is present. This is Leydig cell. You already know the function. Sertoli cell provides nutrition to the spermatogonia during the process of spermatogenesis. And Leydig cell secretes the testicular hormone that is called as androgen, which initiates the process of spermatogenesis. In case of human males, puberty appears at the age of 14 to 16. So at this age, means 14 to 16, some testicular hormones like secretion of androgen occurs from Leydig cell, which causes the meiotic division in the spermatogonia. As I have told you here, the spermatoploidy of spermatogonia is 2n. So this spermatogonia goes through mitosis. First, it goes through mitosis. Why it goes through mitosis? Because as we know that the sperms produced in case of human males are millions in number. So spermatogonia first go through mitosis. And through mitosis, it differentiates and forms many spermatogonia. Many spermatogonia we can say as spermatocytes. And then these spermatocytes, these are called as, or whose ploidy is 2n. Then again they go through meiosis. First they go through meiosis 1. And then through meiosis 2. Clear, students? In meiosis 1, it reduces the chromosome to half the number, means NN. Again, they are reduced to in meiosis 2 into NNNN. Means if the ploidy of, as we know that the human beings contain 23 pair of chromosomes or 46 in number. So the 23 chromosomes is come in during the meiosis 1 to the gametes, that is 23 23, means total number of chromosome is 46, and the spermatogonia when goes through meiosis 1, then 23 gives to the gametes. Again they go through meiosis 2. You know that meiosis 2 is equivalent with mitosis, so here equational division occurs, means 23 here, 23 here, 23 here, and 23 here. In this process, the process of spermatogenesis completed in human male. So how this process completed? As we know that the primary spermatocyte whose ploidy is 2n means it is diploid in number, and the secondary spermatocyte is haploid in number. Secondary spermatocyte forms spermatids, and again these spermatids get mature to form spermatozoa. Clear, students? So we will study more about this in our next class.